Yudhāmanyu.
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 And Vikrantaha.
Vikrantaha.
Mighty.
Mighty.
Uttamaujā.
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 And
Viryavan.
Very powerful.
Very powerful.
Subhadrā.
Subhadrā.
The son of Subhadrā.
The son of
Draupadeya.
Draupadeya.
The sons of Draupadī.
The sons of Draupadī.
Cha.
Cha.
And
Sardave.
All.
Eva.
Eva.
Certainly.
Maharata.
Maharata.
Great chariot fighters. Translation. They are the mighty Yudhāmanyu, the very powerful Uttamaujā, the son of Subhadrā, and the sons of Draupadī. All these warriors are great chariot fighters. Asmākam.
Asmākam.
Our.
To
but
Vishishta,
especially powerful.
Yea,
those.
Tan,
them. Nibodha,
just take note.
Be informed.
Dvijottama,
the best of the brāhmaṇas.
Nāyaka,
captains.
Mama,
my.
Sainyasya,
of the soldiers.
Saṅgyātam,
for information.
Tān,
them.
Bravīmi,
I am speaking.
Your.
Translation. O best of the brāhmaṇas, for your information, let me tell you about the captains who are especially qualified to lead my military force.
So, formerly, 5,000 years ago, the same system, military, ordinary soldiers, then the captain, then the commander-in-chief, as there are gradation in the modern age, the same thing was there. But Maharatha, they had good qualification. Maharatha means alone he could fight with many other charioteers. They are called Atiratha, Maharatha. There are different grades of fighters. So, so far, Pandavas are concerned, their son, Subhadrā. Subhadrā means Abhimanyu. Subhadrā's son. Because he was Subhadrā's son, his name was Subhadrā. Draupadī's son, they are called Draupadeya. In Sanskrit, just like Bhagini, sister, Bhagini. Her son is called Bhagineya. Nephews. So there is link. As soon as we speak Subhadrā, that means Subhadrā's son. The Subhadrā's son, he was only 16 years old at that time. He was married with Uttara, the daughter of Maharaj Virat. So, they are all Maharathas, ordinary, not ordinary fighters. This Abhimanyu was killed by conspiracy by same commander-in-chief. Bhishma, Karna, Dronacharya, Asatthama, they all surrounded him. And they did not allow him to come out. They are very experienced commanders. So this is Kshatriya spirit. You are simply a boy, 16 years old, and he had to be killed by the combined efforts of very, very big commander-in-chiefs. He was so great fighter. Abhimanyu. So, Subhadrā, Draupadī, similarly, Draupadī's sons also there. Sarvaiva Maharatha. Maharatha means one who could fight with 1,000 chariots on the other side. They are called Maharatha. Then Duryodhana, first of all, he pointed out the military strength of the opposite side. This is intelligence. One should take calculation of the opposing elements or the enemy's side. You know, in fighting, the first thing is to take estimation of the enemy's side. How much they are strong, how they have arranged. Then one should calculate how to counteract, how to fight with them. This is intelligence. Without taking any calculation of the other side, if you are not prepared, then how you can become victorious? This is sane proposal. That is, upayam chintayet prajna, apayam cha chintayet. A prajna, an intelligent man, not only think of the bright side, on this business or this fight or this, and so many things we have to deal with. Simply, we should not calculate the brighter side. There is darker side also. We should always think, if there is some thief, if there is some rogue, they cheat us, then what precaution I am going to take? And this is intelligence. If I simply calculate that in this business I will make so much profit, in the meantime somebody comes and cheats me and go away, then... Therefore, upayam chintayet prajna, apayam cha chintayet. Darker side also should be thought. That is intelligence. Just like that way. After calculating the darker side, enemy means darker side. They can defeat me at any moment. That is darker side. So after calculating their strength, then Duryodhana is speaking about his own strength. Asmākam tu viśiṣṭyāji. Viśiṣṭa, not to speak of the ordinary soldier, but viśiṣṭa. Viśiṣṭa means to her, specifically to be mentioned. High officers. Asmākam tu viśiṣṭyāji. Tāṁ nibodho dijottama. He was in commander-in-chief. For 18 days there was fight, and one after another a commander-chief was killed. And 64 crores of men were killed in the battlefield of Kurukshetra. And the battle was finished within 18 days, not lingering for some years, no. Fight to the best capacity and finish the business. So everyone, both the sides, Pandava's side and Kaurava's side, all were killed. The Subhadrā, Draupadī, everyone was killed. And the other side also. Only the five brothers, they remained, and the one grandchild who was in the womb of the mother, he remained. Otherwise, everyone is finished within 18 days. Such a great fight it was. And people from all parts of the world, they joined the battle of Kurukshetra. Somebody was criticizing me that, Swamiji, you are introducing this Hare Krishna movement, people are becoming coward. They simply chant Hare Krishna. So I replied that you will see the power of Hare Krishna movement in due course of time. He required, because there are two battles in India. The battle between Ravan and Ram. Ram-Ravan. The battle of Ramayana. And another battle was battle of Kurukshetra. And in these two battles, the hero was Vaishnava and Vishnu. In the Ram-Ravan battle, Lord Ramchandra was there and his devotee Hanuman, Vajrangaji. Similarly, in the battlefield of Kurukshetra, Krishna was there and his devotee Arjuna was there. So, Vaishnavas, they do not simply chant Hare Krishna. If there is need, they can fight under the guidance of Vishnu and become victorious. Vaishnavas, one qualification is, out of 26 qualifications, one qualification is dokkha, expert. If there is need of fighting, they can fight like very expert. That is also needed. Krishna consciousness does not mean one-sided. Krishna is all-pervading. The Krishna consciousness movement also should be all-pervading. It should touch everything, even politics, sociology, everything, if required. That is the end. Because Krishna's mission is yadā yadā hi dharmasya glāni bhavati bhārata paritrānāyam sādhunām vināśāya ca duṣkṛtām. There is two missions. Not only to give protection to the devotees, but also to kill the demons. They kill the demons. That is one side. So the devotees of Krishna should be trained up both ways. Not only to give protection to the devotees, to give them encouragement, but if need be, they should be prepared to kill the demons. That is Vaishnavism. It is not cowardism. When need be. Generally, a Vaishnava is non-violent. Just like Arjuna. In the beginning, he was non-violent. Vaishnava. He said, Krishna, what is the use of this fighting? Let them enter. So by nature he was non-violent, but he was induced by Krishna to become violent. Then your non-violence will not help. You become violent. You kill them. I want. So if Krishna wants, we shall be prepared to become violent also. And Krishna, that is open secret. That paritranam sadhunam vinashaya ca duskritam. Two business of Krishna, two sides. So those who are devotees of Krishna, they should be trained up both ways. They should be prepared. But generally, there is no question of becoming violent. Unnecessary. As the modern politicians, unnecessarily they declare war. A Vaishnava does not do so. No, unnecessarily, there is no need of war. When it was completely impossible to settle up the things between the Pandavas and the Kauravas, then Krishna said, all right, then there must be fight. When Duryodhana declined to spare in a portion of land holding the suchagra, the point of a needle, he refused that I cannot spare him so much land which can hold the point of a needle. Oh. Then the war was declared. There is no question of settlement. Otherwise, Krishna requested that these five Pandavas, they are Kshatriyas. They cannot become merchant or brāhmaṇa. Brāhmaṇa's profession is paṭan, pāṭhan, jajan, jājan, dān, pratigya. Brahman can take charity from others. A sannyasi can take charity from others. Not a kshatriya or grihastha. No. That is not allowed. So, they are kshatriyas. They cannot take the profession of a brahmana, neither they can take the profession of a mercantile man, businessman. They must have some land so that rule over, take taxation, and that is their living means. So, spare only five villages to these five brothers and settle up. Lord Duryodhana replied, no sir. What do you speak of five villages? We cannot spare even so much land which can hold the point of needle. Then the war was. So Vaishnava, they are non-violent. But if need be, they can become violent for Krishna's sake. This is the battle of Kurukshetra. So, anyone? Or end here? All right, end here. Chant Hare Krishna.